Check, check. We good? Check, one, two. All right, we ready? There we go. Good evening and welcome to HBTV's first annual Night at the Movies. First, I just wanted to thank all of you for your commitment and dedication this year. Your support as parents is part of the reason why this year was so successful. A few housekeeping items. First, I just wanted to reiterate that there is no food or drink in the PAC. That's this place right here. So if you could all help us out, just make sure that we don't bring that party into here. Second, we're recording this event tonight. If you would like to get a copy, we are selling DVDs out in the front lobby for $10. All of the proceeds go straight back to here. That's how we afford to take students onto trips. That's how we get new equipment. So please consider buying a DVD of tonight's performance. I hope you will please consider buying a DVD. Finally, we are creating what I would call a mural up front in the hallway. I'm sure you guys all took a look at that. Those are student works. They shot the film, they took a picture, and they created a movie poster. I hope that one day we can line that hall completely with posters. If you would like to have one of your own movie posters that your child has created, I can get you one of those for $30. Just see me after tonight. All right. I created this event in recognition of the tremendous achievements that our students do on a daily basis. This year alone, we have covered over 60 live events. We have covered every single football game live, including the state tournament and the championship. We covered both men's and lady Wildcat basketball games live, including Har-Ber and Springdale's state championship run. Yes, we covered that as well. We have shot videos for Arkansas Career and Technical Education, Stamp Out Smoking, Internal Har-Ber videos, pep rallies, athletic signing days, news stories across Northwest Arkansas, and impacted lives right here in our own community. On top of that, students have received over 70 awards this year. That is the most that one year has ever accomplished. All of this is a truly tremendous feat. So tonight, we are here to honor their work and recognize the commitment to not only Har-Ber, but the community as well. We'll be right back. That's pretty incredible. My favorite shot was probably Alex Dalton smelling the Pop-Tart. All right, so I told the students when I first had the concept of this event that it would just be a showcase of the top videos of the year. And as I began to go more in depth in planning, I just couldn't keep it that way. I felt like this absolutely had to be some type of award ceremony, that I personally needed to recognize the hard work of certain individuals. So that's what we're going to do. If I call your name tonight, please come up to the stage. As you're walking up here, we'll play your video, and then you will receive your award. All right, let's get to it. The first award of the night goes to the student that has improved the most throughout the year. As a sophomore, this student stood out because she was outgoing, always laughing, and it was just a joy having her in class. As a junior, she came into the class, and I wasn't sure what to expect. I can honestly say that she quickly rose above all the expectations, and she has become a leader in this program. I can't remember how many times she came to me stressed with tears in her eyes because she truly was a perfectionist. Her answer always was, "I just want to get better." Well, I can honestly say that after I watched one of her final projects, I found myself wanting more. And that's what this industry is all about, making people forget that they are watching a movie and connecting with others. I'll never forget one of the conversations I had with her. I asked her, "Why do you get stressed out and sad all the time?" And she simply replied, "I just want people to be proud of me." I've never been more proud of her than I am today. She is a leader in the program, and next year she will without a doubt be an inspiration to the underclassmen. This year's Most Improved Award goes to Grace Sugg.
Career educational technology is becoming a more viable option for students, and the recent expo at Pittsburgh State University is proving just that.
We are one of only two high schools that have been invited back to this huge construction expo at Pittsburgh State. There are over 200 different vendors from Caterpillar, John Deere, Milwaukee, Hilltie, and all these companies, construction companies alike, that are here for these students for career opportunities and to show off all of their equipment that they brought up. And students are also allowed to operate that equipment.
Well, what it is to give the students an idea, if it's our own students, the materials. It's not companies looking to hire our students. That's done in the fall. This is companies that produce products that our students are going to use when they get out. So this is a chance for them to expose the students to all the different products that are out there. So then when they get out there and they're on a project and they need a certain tool or a certain product, they've got an idea of, you know, this is company. I remembered it at the expo days, whether it's Hilti or whatever. Oh yeah, I remembered that. That's the company we can go get that from.
Attendees of this expo specialize in the construction and architectural drafting classes at Har-Ber High School. They were given the opportunity to become hands-on learners.
A particular group of students are all juniors, some seniors, and they are all involved in our construction programs or our CNC classes, or in the architecture and drafting departments areas of Har-Ber High School. Out of that group, we selected the students that we felt like would be a good fit for what the education opportunities are here at Pittsburgh State.
I'm majoring in manufacturing engineering technology. I came here kind of off a random thing. I took a class that I didn't know anything about called Introduction to CNC. And I ended up falling in love with it, and I talked to Mr. Hoffius about, you know, where I could go to, you know, expand that, and he said to come up here and try it out, and I was set, and I moved up here in August, and from then on, I've never regretted it.
With recent integration of graphic design and interior design, the field is now opening up to the female demographic as well.
In the School of Construction, we partner with the construction students, and our students have been minors in construction for quite a while. And starting this fall, we have our own program where we have developed a curriculum that incorporates graphic design, interior design, and construction management all together into one degree. And our students have a lot of opportunities. That combination makes them very marketable.
The pressure of life after high school is always on a graduating student's mind. But with a career in the technical field such as construction, the job placement percentage leaves no doubt of success after high school.
The main thing is when they leave, these people really help them get jobs. So their placement rate is really very close to 100%. The internships that they offer here are phenomenal. Students that need that kind of, they're required to do internships, at least two. Most of those companies pay for that, so it's a great way for students to earn an income. But the main thing is that they're able to help these students in a much smaller setting, so to help them excel.
Besides that, I'm also getting a great education, great opportunities here. I got tons of Pledge Brothers that have internships all over the nation. They good paying jobs. They can't say that they place 100% of the students, but it's basically 100%. Everybody has a job coming out of here. It's hard not to when you go to work or go to class, get your work done, and make good grades. So I just love it up here. I really do.
Opportunity, dedication, hard work, and commitment. An accurate representation of what it takes to be a continued learner. Experience with Har-Ber High School Construction and partnering with Pittsburgh State University. Success is only a small step away. For HBWN, I'm Grace Sugg.
All right, our next award is what we call our Har-Ber Excellence Award. This award goes to the individual who demonstrates what it truly means to show pride in Har-Ber while maintaining excellence in their craft. This student is one of the hardest working individuals I've ever come across. She worked every basketball game, every football game, and almost every concert that we had. In total, it was over 40 live events. At one point in time, I began to feel bad, and I said, you know, you don't have to do this. And she said, no, I want to. I want to be there. That, to me, describes selfless individual who wants to succeed, who wants to inspire others, and who wants to not only get better, but also give back to the community. And how could we not recognize that incredible effort? This year's Har-Ber Excellence Award goes to Raven Cooks. Now, I would love to show you an entire basketball game or football game to demonstrate just what she does throughout the year, but for time's sake, we're just going to kick off our commercial segment, and Raven's commercial is going to start it off.
Sir, because she smoked, she couldn't pay rent. Because she can't pay rent, she lives in a box. Because she lives in a box, she has to ask for change. Because she asked for change, she gets beat up for her money. Because she got beat up, she passes out. Because she passes out, the box gets stolen.
For the sake of Sarah, for the sake of the children, don't smoke tobacco. Don't get your box stolen.
Press play. Press play for a path full of color and life. Your youth is filled with glorious technicolor, filled with laughter and fun, full of love and friends to share life's precious moments with. Teen smokers are more likely to have panic attacks, anxiety disorders, and depression. Don't be a part of that movement. Don't smoke. Don't start. Live vibrantly. Play your life in color. Visit stampoutsmoking.com today.
Hey, Sherman, can you,
Hello, Kendall. Do you want to play a game?
No.
On my left are 375,000 cigarettes, the amount an average human will consume in a lifetime. You must consume them in 5 minutes to find the key to your salvation. Or... puppies. The choice is yours, but
I choose puppies.
Are you sure? There's still time left.
Pretty sure.
Everyone always chooses the puppies. The choice is yours.
Our next award is our Rising Star Award. This is a student that I see has an incredible amount of potential, is passionate in broadcast journalism, and is constantly trying to get better. As a first-year student, he struggled. There are several students that take this course as a creative outlet, but have no real desire to pursue this class as a career, and that's okay. I understand. So that's what I expected of him, to come in as a junior, have fun, and continue to learn. I was never more wrong. Something happened over the summer, and he came in with a fire and passion He jumped right into cameras, more advanced techniques, then became extremely passionate in sports. He produced content that went viral online, created anticipation for the coming years. He traveled to Atlanta, Georgia to compete nationally, and this year, as a junior, he received a Student Pillar of Excellence at the Natus Mid-America Emmys, the highest possible award for a television student. All this is incredible, but the defining moment for me was when he came to me and told me, "I finally figured out what I want to do with my life, and you helped me do it. I want to do this." And I said, "Wayne, that's going to look really weird your whole life." I can never be more proud of this student than I am today. The Rising Star Award goes to Ramey Tyler.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure.
You know, when you get old in life, you find out life's a game of inches. So is football. Because in either game, life or football, the margin for error is so small. I mean, one half a step too late or too early, you don't quite make it. One half second too slow, too fast, you don't quite catch it. The inches we need are everywhere around us. They're in every break of the game, every minute, every second. On this team, we fight for that inch. On this team, we tear ourselves and everyone else around us to pieces for that inch. In any fight, it's the guy who's willing to die who's gonna win that inch. And I know if I'm gonna have any life in it, it's because I'm still willing to fight and die for that inch. Because that's what living is. The 6 inches in front of your face. You gotta look at the guy next to you. Look into his eyes. Now I think you're gonna see a guy who will go that inch. You're gonna see a guy who will sacrifice himself for this team because he knows when it comes down to it, you're gonna do the same for him. That's the team, gentlemen.
All right, he's got it completed.
Right, he's got a ton of pressure.
First down. He's keeping now, he's on his horse. Trey Smith over shoulders. Wide open, Trey Smith, touchdown, Har-Ber Wildcat!
First down, he's looking for the end zone.
It's going to be caught for a touchdown.
Roll to the right-hand side.
Har-Ber Wildcat, touchdown! Har-Ber picks it up!
That was incredible.
They have enough for a first down.
Har-Ber wins. The number one team in the state of Arkansas are the Har-Ber Wildcats.
News coverage is always one of the hardest genres to cover. You have to be very well spoken, informative, all while keeping people interested. Our next award goes to the best news reporter. This student came to me as a junior with a desire to be on-air talent. She loves being in front of the camera and is without a doubt a perfectionist. Without a doubt. She quickly excelled in the class as a writer and went on to impress many, including the Arkansas Democrat Gazette. She also received a Student Pillar of Excellence from the Natus Mid-America Emmys, and I believe that that is a first time ever for a first-year student to do so. I have no doubt next year she will be a leader in the program and an inspiration to the underclassmen. This year's best reporter goes to Ashlyn and Grace Brothers.
"84 feet of hardwood. A test of strength, endurance, and commitment. 14 weeks of perseverance and nonstop dedication. a brotherhood that carries through high school.
But with a bloodline of basketball in the family, one athlete looks at this as not only an opportunity to compete, but to work with individuals who all have the same goal in mind.
My dad, he pushes me a lot, and it's for, you know, my best, and I love it. My dad played college ball, my grandpa played college ball, and it was something I just decided to be good at and love. One of the things that draws me to basketball is the brotherhood that forms with all the teams I play for. So it's just a fun environment to be in, and it's an amazing sport.
Avery's natural drive to win and competitive spirit is evident. It's that spirit that inspires others and has driven them to a solid preseason performance, preparing them for the rigorous conference schedule ahead.
He is one of the better players in the 7A West, and we feel like he's one of the better players in the state of Arkansas.
I've never met someone more competitive than Avery Benson. He is, without a doubt, the most competitive person you will ever meet, whether it's flipping a coin and winning that, or if it's the NBA Finals. He's the most competitive person I know.
Avery defines dedication, hard work, and sacrifice. This is the backbone of any team. It's not the points or rebounds averaged per game. It's the ability to lead and inspire others. This is what separates Avery and ultimately makes him a key player on and off the court.
Every possession, he's playing as hard as he can play. We like for our leaders to lead by example. Anybody can talk a good game and just hear their head rattle. But we want to see some we need to see some results. That's one of the things that we talk about being a leader. We want results from our leaders.
He's a team captain, so he's got to keep us all in line. He's got to be a team leader. He's got to know what he has to do, and he has to know what everybody else has to do as well. So that's just more pressure, but I know Avery. I know he can handle that, and he's doing a pretty good job so far.
Averaging 10 points a game, Avery dominates on the court, but his character off the court has not only affected lives, but given some a new sense of belonging.
Yeah. He's made a big impact on my life. Anytime I've needed anything, I go to him, I go to my brother. He basically is like my other big brother. I love him to death. I feel like we are brothers sometimes, and I think that's special. And he's definitely a star in my life for sure.
2007 was Har-Ber's last appearance in the basketball state championship. 9 seasons, 3 coaching changes, and 126 conference games later, this team is prepared to make the difference. And Avery Benson is looking forward to that one thing.
What I look forward to is, us being the underdog, people taking us lightly, and just coming out and showing them what we got, and showing them that we know what we're doing, and that we can compete with anybody.
Competing as only a junior, Avery Benson is just beginning the legacy that he is sure to leave on Har-Ber basketball. Come out and support your Har-Ber Wildcats this season, and be sure to look out for number 21. For WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Almost one out of every 4 students are bullied in school each year.
But did you know that over half the situations stop if a student peer intervenes?
It's time to join together and make a stand.
And whether you're an athlete,
in the band,
or finding your own passion,
stand up, because together we can make the difference.
So, you want answers, your house is in pieces, the flame has met the rain as it subsides. You stand out in the street, soot on your cheek. Up to the ghost in the black blue sky and ask him why.
'Cause it's a long way home, my friend. know you feel alone in the remnants of the kitchen.
Where's Russell at? You didn't think of starting the car with a key before? Acting has always been a struggle for our program. It's hard to convey emotions on camera for anyone, let alone high school students. This year we had several actors and actresses, thanks to Ms. Browncouch and our theater department, that have taken the quality of the production to the next level. Our next award goes to the best actress. It was a tough call this year. The quality of work this year was what I would call the best since the beginning of this program. Since it's our first award show, I just couldn't decide and finally settled on the fact that I don't have to. These two individuals are both relatively new to the program, but their early leadership was something that inspired others around them. They were bombarded with projects and the opportunity to always improve. I'm very proud of their work, and while one is moving on to the next level, the other still has one more year with me, and that is going to be very exciting. This year's Best Actress goes to Sarah Gill and Elizabeth Gonzalez.
Run, Sarah! Go, you gotta get out of here!
Sarah, we gotta go. Come on, we're gonna be in trouble if we don't.
He's always working.
Sarah, we have to leave. He's coming. We're in danger.
What do you want from me? What do you want?
How long has she been like this?
Since the incident.
How are you doing?
I'm just taking it day by day, trying to deal with her.
She's a kid. They go through phases. You guys have already dealt with enough this year.
Yeah.
Let me talk to her.
Okay.
Sarah, my name's Dr. Klein. I was a friend of your mom's.
My mom's dead.
Sarah, don't...
I know she's dead, but that doesn't change the fact that we were friends. What are you drawing?
Toby.
Who's Toby?
My friend.
Oh, I think I'd like to meet him.
You can't.
Why not?
Because he doesn't like you.
Why doesn't he like me, Sarah? 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 Sarah, why doesn't he like me?
He says he's glad that your son died. That way he doesn't have to suffer like you.
Don't say that.
Why would you say that? Sarah!
Why would you say that? Answer me.
Okay, I think that's enough for today.
Here, let's go, sir. Come on.
Sarah, who are you talking to?
Toby.
Oh, okay. Well, I think you need to tell Toby it's time for little girls to go to bed.
Toby, Sissy says go to bed.
I'm so glad you're back to yourself. Just this once.
There we go.
Thank you.
Good job.
Thank
you. Needless to say, don't make Sarah mad. All right, our next award goes to Best News Story. As you may or may not know, broadcast news is extremely demanding. The typical flow for students is they shoot their shows on Monday. Tuesday, we have a production meeting of what is happening to Har-Ber. They decide on their story and set up their interviews. Wednesday, they shoot their interviews and begin the process of shooting their B-roll. Thursday, they finish shooting their B-roll and begin editing, and Friday, they finish their edit. As you can see, it's very fast-paced, and there is no downtime between projects. We have had the privilege of being on one of the top programs in the state of Arkansas for over 7 years now, and needless to say, my expectations are high. However, this package went above and beyond. The way they told the story, captured the interviews, and transitioned their thoughts with stand-ups and voiceovers can only be described as professional and award-winning. In fact, this is the video that received the Student Pillar of Excellence mentioned before, and all three of these students will be honored in October. This year's Best News Story goes to Ramey Tyler, Estrus Valdez, and Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
The gridiron, a test of strength, endurance, and commitment. 100 yards of broken tackles, clutch opportunities, and third down drives that turn men into champions. Football is America's pride and most watched sport, with over one-third of the country tuning in to watch the Saturday Frenzy, the Sunday Night Madness, or the Friday Night Lights. You can be sure to bet that when that victory bell rings, the rest of the city, state, or nation is right there with you. But for one athlete, the biggest challenge is to pick himself up and keep moving forward.
It was my ninth grade year,
and I was kicking a field goal against the Rogers Mounties. I kicked it and I made it, but as soon as my foot came down on the ground, a dude dove at it and snapped it, broke in six places. I took 7 months to recover and actually be cleared to play, and I was on crutches for about the first 3 months. And I owe a lot of it to my friends and my family because they really like helped me through all of it and all through my rehab.
7 months of rehab, intense physical training, not to mention the emotion and psychological battle within, would break almost anyone. But for Jacob Robertson, quitting was never an option.
I never really thought about it because I love the sport and nothing can really keep me from it. I just wanted to come back stronger. I had to work out a lot, lots of rehab, but it was a lot of hard work and a lot of sacrifices, but that's what you need to play here at Har-Ber, lots of sacrifices.
Sacrifice, a key word that Jacob uses to not only be an impact player, but to help his team recognize that you need to play every game as if it were your last.
I think the injury really helped J-Rob in understanding that every play could be your last play. And he does not take for granted playing high school football. He goes out with a passion. He goes out there and plays hard every snap because he realizes that every snap could be his last. You never know what's going to happen. And he plays that way. You know, he has a passion for the game, and he's been given a second chance coming back off this injury because, you know, I think originally when he got injured, I don't think he was ever going to be, they said he probably wouldn't be able to play again. And so, you know, he came back from this thing, got a second chance to play, do what he loves to do, and you can see that on the field as he plays because he plays with an intense passion. He goes as hard as he can all the time.
Through all the pain, all the wins, and even the losses, this injury has shaped his life and taught him one very valuable lesson.
Don't be negative about it, you know? It's not going to do anything but make you stronger if you think about it. You just got to have a good mindset towards it. You just got to be positive throughout the process. It's a lot of hard work, but I think you can overcome anything if you put your mind to it and if you really want to.
Life is full of challenges, disappointments, and sometimes upsets. But the one thing you can never lose is the ability to get up and try again. And for Jacob Robinson, his story has just begun. For WCSN, I'm Ashton Grace Brothers.
Welcome to Har-Ber Wildcat News.
Good morning, Wildcats. Welcome to our final show of Har-Ber Wildcat News this year.
And it is a student-led I'm so sorry.
But the first ever student to be in ninth grade. Fourth. And so after Live in the Snooze, I say, hey, go forget to buy your prom tickets, because we're talking about prom dresses.
Today's show is all about celebrating the seniors on our HBWN team and school-wide.
I'm so confused.
Here at Har-Ber. So we... I really can't do this. Dang it! Segment. Teaching you all tap.
We are so proud of our 2N16 students.
2N16.
We are so proud of our 2000.
Oh my God, dude, this is killing me right now.
We are so proud of our 2016 seniors. Hope you have a success in your future plans.
Completely scrumptious.
Wait, so I'm reading straight. Or I turn and read this way, no. Right?
April 25th through the 29th. They are $50. Okay, we cannot do that.
Yeah, yay, we do. And
then
what?
We held a
this should not be part of the show.
We can.
my lines weren't there.
And the famous HBWM blooper reel. HBWM.
That was so good!
You would think the only historical figure of Valentine's Day is Cupid, who shoots his arrows and makes someone fall in love.
However, the origin of Valentine's Day actually dates back to.
Today we will feature a story on our very own East program as they create awareness on the day. I couldn't help that.
I don't know what to do.
Recently, a partnership with the Springdale Police Department, Fire Department, paramedics, and funeral home took place to demonstrate the importance of staying sober while drinking.
I think I'm going to miss Mr. Sherman the most, and he is the absolute best.
Okay, do you want to come anchor, Sherman?
Hi there, Wildcats. Welcome to Har-Ber Wildcat News. For HBWM, I'm Mr. Sherman.
And I'm Sarah Gill. On today's show, we'll take a look at some students' trip to Pittsburgh University.
That's not all. We cannot forget the new segment of Live Witness News, as well as a story on one group of students that the teleprompter is not running.
Taking a stand in our community, that's what they're doing.
Today is April 28, 2016.
Sometimes we have fun. Director of the Year is one of the most coveted awards. After all, it's the late nights, long days of preparations, and overall vision from the director that can make a film, broadcast, commercial, or whatever genre you are creating for. But the award this year goes to the student for a different reason. This student showed some interest last year in the field and then really took off this year. He took initiative wherever he could, jumping on almost every project out there. He tried writing, acting, directing, cameras, and then he took the opportunity to direct live basketball games. Yes, he did every single one of them. He has approached me numerous times about college and where to go, and when I asked him, "What is it exactly you want to do with your life?" he replied, "I want your job." I'm not sure whether to take that as a compliment or a threat, but regardless, his passion and dedication is obviously something to be recognized. This year's Director of the Year Award goes to Kendall King.
I feel like I'm so different on the inside and that the world won't accept me for who I really am.
8 7 6 5
Dearest Susan, boot camp is tough, but I'm learning a lot. Sergeant Chapman has really taken me under his wing since the first day.
You are here because your country needs more cameramen than ever before! Just pressing the record button does not make you a cameraman! I'll make you a cameraman. You will shoot harder. You will be focused.
70 to 200. This will get you a clean headshot in 20 minutes.
You will expect the unexpected, and I will turn you ladies into men.
Where are you from, Cupcake?
I'm from Arkansas, Drill Sergeant.
Do not address me. What's the first rule of being a cameraman? That's right. Cameraman, do not speak. If you want to speak, speak with your eyes. The last thing I want to hear when I'm watching my beloved show is for Cupcake to be whispering sweet nothings in my ear. Do you get me?
Sergeant Chapman says that we should always expect the unexpected. I think I'm one of the top in my class.
Prepare to assemble. Faster, faster, come on now. Let's go, Cupcake. Move it, Snowflake. Faster. Inspection time. Good. Next time, sweetheart. Satisfactory.
Oh, what do we have here? He's a cute little fella.
Always expect the unexpected, huh?
Keep scrubbing, Cupcake.
Yesterday was our first shooting exercise. Don't worry, Susan. There's a lot of action out there, but it's nothing I can't handle.
Focus! We're shooting action here! Not the Ellen Show!
Volleyball!
Nice hit, Buttercup! Expect the unexpected!
Big ball!
Oh! I've been hit!
Say shooting! Cupcake!
I wouldn't let you shoot a children's birthday party.
So, dearest Susan, please do not fret. My time here has turned me into a man of my country. And I will return home soon. Love, your son, Kendall.
Cupcake! Turn that light off, or I'll come over there and make you wipe out till your fingers bleed!
Night, Mom. Night, Dad.
Night, sweetheart.
Cupcake, house lights down. Call time on 500.
John Chapman, you tell our son goodnight.
Yes, ma'am. Good night, Kendall. To the individual that has really pushed the limits of the program, he or she excels and others look to them as an inspiration and for guidance. The award goes to a student this year who came to me as quite the surprise. Before this year, I didn't know the student. He came from a different school and joined the broadcast side of the program. I've had this in the past, and honestly, it's always a challenge. It's hard to know what knowledge the student knows from previous schools, and frankly, Har-Ber works at such a high level that it's hard for any student to keep up. This student immediately jumped in and was teaching students techniques that even I didn't know. He wanted to continue to further his education. I can't remember a single day where he wasn't asking me, how do I do this, or what does this do? He has already gained an internship in the professional world, and he is only a junior. I would call this student a pivotal part of the program, and without him, I don't believe the program would have been as successful as it was this year. This year's Broadcast Journalist of the Year goes to Estrus Valdez.
...1,344 minutes, 42 games, 3 seasons. That is what a typical athlete in a 7A West will experience if they're lucky. But for one athlete, she rose above all others and is setting an example for not only her newfound teammates, but for future Wildcats for years to come.
Yeah, I watched JC when she was smaller, like playing with Sonics, and you know, we knew she had a lot of potential. So I just kept an eye on her and really watched her hard as a 7th and 8th grader at Central, and just decided that she would be our first 9th grader to move up because she had the potential to step, you know, just come out and help us immediately at the high school level.
I always wanted to play up for Har-Ber, but I didn't know if it was going to happen. And I mean, it wasn't going to be a make it or break it deal if I didn't. I like Central, but I really wanted to play for Har-Ber. And my biggest fear probably coming up for Har-Ber was if I was going to be accepted or not as a 9th grader. And thankfully I came up here, I proved my role, I came up here and I was accepted.
For Coach Sandy Wright, she immediately recognized something much deeper than the simple talent of the game. It was a drive and determination that came from within.
First of all, she loves basketball, and that's, you know, she plays hard and gives it all she has every time she steps out on the court. She's a good ball handler and good shooter, and she has speed, and she's a 5'10 guard, so she had some good characteristics of being a good guard at the high school level.
Pure talent, like, honestly, when she walks out onto the floor, you know that she's going to have a great game, and that's what's awesome. So her impact to the team is more bigger picture. She just helps us all out, and that's what's really cool about how she plays.
JC Higgins, the first freshman athlete to be given the opportunity to play at the varsity level. At just 14 years old, she quickly rose to be an inspiration for her teammates and a leader on and off the court.
Well, JC's vocal. She likes to talk, and, you know, she leads by example probably more than anything. And, you know, people can look at her other teammates and see that, you know, this is how hard I need to go. And, you know, I like that. She's a good quarterback.
You always need someone that's very talented at what they do and is able to, like, keep that quiet. You know, she knows she can score, but how she approaches that and how she carries herself with that is completely different than anybody else that I've played with.
I feel like going into practice with a winning mentality is really what sets me apart from a lot of people. I feel like I go in there and I work as hard as I can, and that pushes other people to work as hard as they can. So I feel like it's my role to lead the team.
With now over 3 years of experience at the varsity level, JC has learned opportunities like this come only to those who work for it. And one lesson that she has learned above all others are words that future Wildcats should take into consideration.
Just always be willing to put in hard work. You're not going to get good if you don't put in your hardest work. Don't ever goof off in practice, because practice how you play, really. I've always learned that if you work hard, you play hard. If you mess up, then hustle always makes up for it.
With the history set, JC Higgins continues to demonstrate what it means to be a leader. Though the future is uncertain, the name JC Higgins will continue to echo through the halls of Har-Ber long after her years here with the Lady Wildcats. Be sure to look out for number 13, along with the rest of the Lady Wildcats. And remember, opportunities come for those who work for it. For WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
The most popular aspect of our program is the filmmaking spectrum. Film was my original background, and so I'm very passionate about it as well. I tell students that it is the only thing that can bring 300 or 400 people together in the same room, and for an hour and a half, they all share the same moment, happiness, fear, or triumph. Suspension of disbelief is what we call it. For that hour and a half, you forget that you're watching a movie, and you are transported into another world. One of our last awards of the night is Best Film. I can honestly say that I have never been more proud of a film than I am of the one we're about to see. I personally think it is the best film that has ever come from this program, and that is saying a lot. The students that made this film really harnessed the essence of filmmaking. There are so many different roles that go into the production that all have to work together, or it just doesn't quite translate on the screen. For the first time in 4 years that I've been here, I had no critiques. Frankly, this film was better than something that I could have done. The script writing was incredible. The acting actually made me connect with characters. Camera movements were perfect. Lighting, exposure, audio, it all fell into place. This film is the culmination of 3 years of hard work from a group of seniors that never stopped working together to get better, and this film is just a testimony of the quality of work that we will see from them in the very near future. This year's best film goes to Amber Carnish, Elizabeth Gonzalez, Kendall King, Hannah Harris, McKenna Harris, and Nora Bayari. Sorry if I butchered that last one.
Growing up, my sister and I were inseparable. I can't remember a single day where we didn't get in trouble, find something to fight about, or laugh until we cried.
Arrow, come here.
But no matter what, we both knew that in the end, we would always be there for each other. I knew her better than anyone. People overuse that phrase too often, but I didn't. They could see it in my eyes that I would be there for her through anything, through heartbreak, through cancer. hardest part wasn't watching her fade away, or even the thought of losing her. It was watching her continue to laugh, continue to love, and forget the fact that she wasn't okay, that I wasn't okay. I never understood how she could just pretend. To the world, she was just one person, but to me, she was the world. And then, nothing. Amber, do you remember how Mom and Dad used to tell us that life was a beautiful thing? Well, I'm going to be completely honest with you. Life is a constant roller coaster of ups and downs. People fail to mention all the hardships and heartbreak that you'll face. Life is taken for granted, and I now know that more than ever. There are so many things I wish I had said, and so many things I still wish I had time to do. The truth is, I didn't know what to say. I know you hated not being able to fix me, but in my last days, I didn't want my memories filled with complaints of sorrow and anger.
Hey, you want to come play with us?
Okay. Oh, stay right there. You would have wanted this.
I wanted to remember the good things in life. Like your goofy laugh or Mom's warm hugs and Dad's jokes that we always made fun of. I know that 30 days seem short, but I learned a lot. Life is a messy web of struggles. But that is the true beauty of it. Everyone dies, not everyone really lives. We get to experience life. We get to experience the warmth of family, the fear of the unknown, and sometimes the sorrow of losing something that means the most to us. We aren't in control of our fate, but we are in control of creating our own happiness and who we choose to love. I chose to love you like no one else, every single day. You are my happiness. It's time for you to go find yours. I love you, Amber.
Ditto.
Guys, we'll wait on you. Let's see what we got. Is Nora here today? Okay. Kenna? Good job. One more time.
get over so here.
Thank you.
All right. Pretty incredible stuff so far, huh? Our final award of the night is bittersweet. Students come and go, but you never realize how much they impact your program until they leave. I sat and thought about every year that I have been here and realized that there was always one student that everyone looked up to. One student that inspired all the others, one student that was always on everyone's mind the following year. The first year it was Robert Crisp. Everyone the following year said, I want to be like Robert. I want to shoot films like Robert. The second year is Brandon Bucherry. He's in the audience tonight. Where are you at? I don't know, it's way in the back. There he is. The second year was Brandon Bucherry. Last year it was Andrew Lyle. I thought, you know, how incredible is it that we have students that leave Har-Ber that truly made an impact on students' lives? That is what this next award is all about. Our final award of the night is our Legacy Award. It will be a new tradition in which a student will be awarded a plaque, and that plaque will hang in the classroom so every year students can look up to someone that has truly shaped this program. This year's Legacy Award goes to an individual who has shown massive growth. As a sophomore, she was timid and reserved, but was one of the hardest workers in the class. That year, she went on to win first in the state for digital cinema productions and placed 12th nationally. And she was only a sophomore. As a junior, she started to find her voice and partnered with others who could help her excel. Again, she placed first in the state for digital cinema productions, and this time, first nationally. The first time Arkansas had ever done that in 50 years. This year, she was a leader in the class, directed others on how to get better, pushed her own peers, shot on weekends after school, created content that has far exceeded anything this program has ever seen before, and will be leaving this program with 18 awards, 2 state titles, 1 national title, best cinematographer in the state of Arkansas, and 3 student pillars of excellence from the Natus Mid-America Emmys. She has truly been an inspiration to others around her, and I have no doubt that when she leaves this program, she will be successful wherever she may go. This year's Legacy Award goes to Amber Carnish.
What does it mean to be a storyteller? Is it about the awards? The glamour? Or is it something much deeper? Maybe it's a suspension of disbelief. For that brief moment in time, we allow people to escape their own realities and take a journey into ours. In that moment, it doesn't matter who you are, where you come from. In that moment, we are all united. It's about the journey. Because let's face it, life moves fast.
Run, Sarah!
And if you don't stop and look around every once in a while, you just might miss it. We get to capture happiness. We get to capture memories. We get to capture life. 24 frames at a time. Life at 24, because every frame counts.
I just want to read the inscription that will hang in the classroom. In recognition of outstanding dedication and commitment to your craft, Har-Ber Television presents Amber Carnish with the HBTV Legacy Award. As you move on to the next story in your life, know that you have made this program better. Thank you for continuing to be an inspiration to talented storytellers for years to come. And know that you are not just leaving as a graduate of 2016 class, but as a legacy for others to follow. Congratulations. It's been amazing this year. We really have produced some of the best content that I think we've had the opportunity to. We've got one more final video for you tonight, and after that, you are free to go. Thank you for coming out tonight. We want to thank Dr. Brackett for the continued support. He's the one that allows us to travel and compete at the highest level. Thank you to Dr. Rollins for your leadership and guidance, Trent Jones for being an advocate for the Har-Ber High School television program, and I want to personally thank my wife. The support she gives me keeps me grounded, and she continues to be my own personal inspiration. Just look at her. Just look at her. Be sure to get a copy of a DVD on the way out. They are $10 each, and all proceeds go straight back into the program. Also, if you want a copy of any of the posters that you see out there in the hallway, I can get those to you for $30. Just see me after this event. Thank you all for coming out tonight. Here is our final video. Seniors, this is for you.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again, when I see you.
I've been in this class for the past 3 years, and over those years, I've met a bunch of people, and we have made friendships with them, and I'll probably miss making those friendships the most.
TV has taught me to basically take my imagination to the next level and reach my fullest potential. It's taught me to persevere in times, like, it's really hard. You have a lot of deadlines to meet, and then you also have to work as a team with a lot of people. You have to bend your ideas.
My favorite moment from TV was whenever we did a package over 1,000 Ways to Cry. Whenever Gerardo just tried to cry like a fake cry, it made me laugh so much.
Sherman just makes, like, just the way he is, it kind of creates moments. Probably some of my favorite are when he gives out tardies, because he, like, you know, he thrives on that. And, it's one of his big things.
The people that are in the class, because there's always different types of people that go to that class, from like jockeys to like people in drama.
What I'll miss most is probably the chance to hang out with my buddies and to see Sherman always handing out attention to everyone except me.
TV's taught me a lot of communication skills, I feel like. Talking to people, meeting new people, because, you know, one day we'll have to go get like an interview or something like that.
I think what TV has taught me the most is timing and communication. Whenever Sherman says he wants something on time, if he says he wants it done in a week, you have to make sure it's done in a week.
TV's taught me like everything. It's taught me to have a work ethic, turning things in on time, not procrastinating, you know, jumping on my work or at least starting, and then also just taking a level of excellence for my work.
What I will miss most from TV is probably Mr. Sherman messing with us, or the videos, having fun while we're shooting, just everyone being together and having a good time while we're shooting.
My favorite moment from TV is seeing the final product that I make and seeing the outcome and everything we've worked so hard for weeks on.
It's taught me a lot of responsibility, like your account, to be held accountable for my own work.
It's taught me to like become more of a leader and like time management, because, you know, he literally just gives us projects and like lets us go with it throughout the week, and, you know, it's up to us to like you know, manage our time and get it done.
I think what I'll miss most about TV is going to competitions and just competing in general with my teammates. Everything about the competition we went to was just amazing.
I will miss Sherman's antics the most, because being in his classroom is just such a fun environment. You have so much freedom, but it's safe freedom. You can do a lot with Sherman.
proud of you guys. Have a good night.